Hello there, my name is Taro Hanula, and today we will do a genetic algorithm for a neural network. Just to remind that I'm using GMS2 Studio 2.3, I'm a self-taught in machine learning. Now, in previous videos, we have made forward and backward passes. So currently, we can make predictions on a neural network with a gradient descent. This learning is supervised because we use input-output pairs, and tell explicitly what the network did wrong. In other hand, there is unsupervised learning, where we don't have such labeled training data. Learning happens more of a self-discovery. Now today's topic is genetic algorithm, which draws inspiration from natural selection for doing unsupervised learning. Unlike with a gradient descent, the genetic algorithm can apply more freely, and the steps are more of a guidelines how to implement it. So don't take my approach as a ground truth, but one way to interpret it. There are three steps for algorithm. Selection, crossover, and mutate. First step is selection, where we wind out the elite from a population. These are individuals, which perform the best from their generation. On second step, crossover, we create offsprings from elite, which will replace the rest of the population. So new generation is populated with elite and their children. The third step is mutate, where we select part of population which will experience random mutations. Doing these three steps from the new generation. Because we kept elite from last generation, the performance should be at least par with the last generation. But the new offsprings might outperform them and become new elite. So, learning actually happens by random chance. It's just that we kept selecting best ones, which eventually leads to good results. Now to wind out the elite, we need a way for evaluating population, which can be done by using witness function. Defining this function might be hardest part. The evaluation is task dependent, and alignment with the wanted behavior isn't guaranteed. So there isn't a single true function. But for the simplest tasks, it can be distance or time. Just to mention that this algorithm isn't solely for neural networks, but can be applied to other things too. Population is just collection of solutions to given problem, and we stir them up until the answers are good enough. I will create another folder, which will hold functions related to genetic algorithm. This time, we don't make these as method functions into layer constructors, so you could create different variations of algorithm more easily. I wrote steps as three functions, which user should call in correct order. These have few assumptions. First, population is an array of any struct or instances, and each of them has a network. So it's not directly a collection of networks, but specimens with their networks. Second assumption is that our population uses the same architecture for all networks, so we only change parameter values. Third, each specimen stores a result of witness function in variable witness. In selection, we assume that the population has already been evaluated, and we can sort them by their witness variable. In crossover, we do selection of elite by choosing part of from sorted population and replace rest with offsprings. This is done by looping through replaceable portion and modifying their parameters with random parts from parents. We can create offspring however we want. The main point is generating new solutions from elite, use existing information. We don't know what kind of performance this mixing will lead to, it can be better or worse. To keep code simpler, function uses only two random parents, and it doesn't even check whether A and B happen to be the same. That is fine, as that's like cloning. I decided to do actual crossover modifications in separate function. This is because the code will otherwise get messy. After we have created offsprings, we want to apply mutations, so we can create new information outside the population. I let the user decide which part of the population is affected, so you could include elite too. Now the main function loops through all layers of selected population and call separate layer mutation function. Now within this new function, we will have a switch statement, as each type of parametric layers will need their own behavior. Though currently we only need case for dense layer, as we can skip input layer. This is like a crossover function. We have a switch to specify behavior by layer type. Again, you can do mutations however you want. Here, I just add random values to random parameters. Now that we have the necessary functions, I'll create examples where AI tries to survive as long as possible by avoiding obstacles. First, the simple one. Blocks only come from one direction. Let's start by creating floor, wall, and obstacle generator. Next, we will create a specimen object. It will have most bare-bone network there can be. Single input and single output. That means network has only single weight and bias as a learnable parameters. Can't be simpler than that. There are some necessary variables to play the game, which must be reset whenever round starts over. I won't have an explicit fitness function. Instead, fitness is updated during the gameplay. Main objective is survival, so fitness increases while the specimen is alive. As a secondary objective, I want to reduce jumping. In this little game, specimen gets information by raycasting. This will tell a normalized distance to colliding wall, if there is one in given range. I will make a ray function bit later. The result is whether AI press jump button or not. This uses a threshold of activation, which could also be its own activation function. Finally, we need the specimen to play the game. This is simple. It can jump only on the floor, and control jump height by releasing the button. The control object oversees the game and tells some information for us. Most important thing is that we have population array, which is target for functions. In this example, controller will apply genetic algorithm whenever all specimens are out of the game, though it can apply it after whatever condition has been met. After applying the algorithm, round should be restarted with a new generation. For ray function, we use modified script from GML script page. This will tell a normalized distance as 0 to 1 for objects in given direction. So, the task is about jumping at the correct distance, which the specimen solved by finding good relationship between weight and bias. There can be many correct combinations, and because our game is so simple, most likely one or two specimen already start with a good parameters. As generations go, rest of population also learns to play the game, as parameter values from elite become dominant. Sometimes, bad specimens survive by chance, which means next generation will base on these. This hinders learning because population can get stuck with bad parameters. Let's try commenting out the second part of our fitness function. Because being on the air isn't punished anymore, specimen might learn just constantly jump. The performance is worse than we had before. But because it is good enough to survive, they can become dominant. Population can get stuck with the behavior we perceive as a bad. This can render a crossover useless as population isn't diverse enough and mutation rates might not be enough to find new solutions. So defining fitness function is important. But sometimes bad behavior emerges anyway, and in those cases, it's fine to try again with a different population. Now that example was really simple, so let's create another one, which is a bit more complex. The idea is same, avoid obstacles, but this time they can come from any direction. This means our specimen are helpless now. They don't see walls coming from other directions, and can't even avoid ones coming from above or below. Therefore, specimen need more inputs and ability to move sideways. But this arises a new problem. Specimen can fall off from the floor. This will be a losing condition, and specimen needs more information to avoid it. So, let's reserve enough inputs and outputs to accommodate all new behavior. Input is updated by checking wall all around itself, and then downward for the floor. The jump pattern is same as before, but now we have a second output for moving sideways. The control object won't have any real difference, it is just the game that has changed. If you have YYC available, now would be a good time to use it, because arrays are a bit expensive, and network is now more complex. Also I put a larger population in there. Most likely specimen don't know what to do and can't survive long, as they have much more parameters, so chance landing on correct combinations at the start is slight. But by using genetic algorithm, we update parameters with each generation. So let's see how these little guys do after 100 generations. Most of the time, solution is found if there is one. How long this takes is up to complexity of environment, network and fitness function, but also to random chance. Also, for a given task there must be enough complexity for the network, but too complex makes learning slower. So, population learns to avoid blocks, but still some situation seems to be tricky. But currently our specimens are just reactive. They don't know anything of what they have seen or done previously. They make decisions only to this exact moment they experience. So some situations might need information about previous states. But this is good enough example to showcase that algorithm works. To recap, we have made genetic algorithm to solve the given task. In our implementation, population learns by three evolutionary steps. Select most fit individuals, create offspring, and then give mutations. How we evaluate performance depends on the task, and aligning this with wanted behavior can be hard. Because there are not hard definitions on how to implement genetic algorithm, it is more of a build around the task. So there can be a lot of tinkering with finding the right network architecture, correct inputs, good fitness function, and when actually apply the algorithm. Eventually, we reach point where new generations don't yield better results. This is when we finish our training. And if results are sufficient, we can take one of the best networks as our result of the training. The functions created in this video just provide one way of implementing these steps. But anyway, we have now two ways of training network, with a gradient descent and genetic algorithm. To use trained network later, we need functions for saving and loading them, which we currently don't have. So, that's our call in the next video. Joten mukavaa illan jatkoa. Moikka!